Hello.
So this video.
Yeah.
Hello, so this video, I'm going to be talking about Kool-Aid. Yes, Kool-Aid, while I'm going to make some Kool-Aid later, but right now, I'm making some cheddar bait biscuits. So I'm like, let me go ahead and do this real quick. Okay, so anyways, so the oven preheated. So Kool-Aid. Okay, so we're talking about, okay, I wasn't talking about anything yet. Okay, Demetra. Okay, so what am I about to say? Oh yeah, so I have a story about Kool-Aid. So this can be, I wouldn't say a black box reading, it could be, or just me talking, telling somebody about some Kool-Aid, like don't drink it, or drink it, or make it yourself, something. But a time, well, I'm gonna tell you the story, then I'm gonna lead up to the Kool-Aid part. Hopefully I'll make this video quick. Okay, so I was, again, this is a story about me being pregnant with my son Melvin at the time. So it was one day when I was assaulted by one of my baby daddies. His wife assaulted me while I was pregnant with my son Melvin. And I had to go in the ambulance to the hospital and everything and all of that. And this wasn't fun. I have two sons by this guy. His name is Lamont. All this is facts. All this is true. So I had two sons by him. And both of them was in the car witnessing the assault. And before the assault happened, you know, they dad was just standing. We was in the Walmart parking lot. His wife done blocked me in. So I couldn't leave the parking spot or whatever, and I back in. I like to back in. But anyways, the truck was blocking me from leaving. Needless to say, before the physical altercation happened, we outside of the cars, and I'm telling my children's dad or whatever, like, look, get your girl. I'm pregnant. I ain't trying to fight. Like, get your girl. And he was just standing, like, leaning up against the other car. Like, you know, like, I ain't gonna say nothing. Like, I'm scared of my girl, you know. She told me not to say nothing. I mean, he ain't say that, but the look on his face was like, I can't say anything. You know, I ain't gonna get into it. And I'm telling him, like, get your girl. I'm pregnant. And mind you, this is in front of our two sons. They was in my car. So, I say this to say that. This was during the time when, like I said, I was newly pregnant with, I believe I was 6 weeks pregnant with Melvin. And I had just found out a couple of weeks beforehand that I was pregnant. And Melvin's dad, when I told him that I was pregnant, the first thing he was like, you know, I don't want it. Get, you know, that thing done. The termination done. I'm just say that word. Get the termination done. I don't want it. Like, those are the first words that was out of his mouth after about 2 to 3 seconds of silence, you know. So, during this time, going back to when I told Melvin that I was pregnant, like I said, that was the first words out of his mouth. And then he was like, he kept calling me and texting me like every single day, like every shoot. I could be over exaggerating about this part, but it seemed like he was texting me and calling me like every hour saying, hey, you need to get this done. I don't want to have a baby. You need to get this done. And then eventually he started trying to turn it around on me, like far as trying to put it on me, like he helping me out. Like, come on, Demetra, you don't need to have another baby. You got 3 kids already, you know, and then you already got 2 baby daddies. So if you have a child by me, you'll have 4 kids. And 3 baby daddies, you need to think about, you know, think about your kids and think, you know, like trying to flip it around on me, like he helping me out if I get this termination done, you know. And I'm like, I'm keeping my baby. So needless to say, that went on for a good maybe a week and a half or so, maybe 2 weeks that he kept saying, you know, get this thing done or whatever. So eventually I was like, you know what, I don't want to hear that anymore. So I told him, like, you know what, fine. I'm going to go call these people and I'll set up an appointment. Wish I did. I had him on three-way, and I called the clinic, which was down in Baltimore somewhere. I think it was called Planned Parenthood. Ooh, that's a lot of cheese, but oh well. In Baltimore. So I called them, set up an appointment. He on the three-way, you know, so I wanted him to know that I did it. But of course, I really was not going to go through with it. I just didn't want to hear him keep telling me to get it. And he was saying the word, the AB word, which I'm not going to say. That's why I'm just saying termination word. So I called on the three-way. He heard it. And then appointment was like 3 days later, 2 to 3 days later, something like that. And it was around Memorial Day weekend. And I believe I found out I took a pregnancy test like in early May, in early May-ish. So this was like getting close to the end of May or basically at the end of May. So made the appointment. You know, he heard it. Melvin heard it. And how can I say this? So yeah, he heard it and then he stopped telling me to get it because it was like no need to keep telling me, not asking me, but telling me to get it done, you know. Now since he, you know, heard the appointment, it was just like, okay, good. I don't gotta, you know, tell her to get it done because she made the appointment. Whoop-de-whoop. It's all good. So, of course, in my mind, I'm like, I'm not going to go through with this, but I ain't trying to have him keep texting me and calling me, you know, talking about all that, you know, whatever. So, the day before the surgery or the procedure, whatever, you know, want to be called, I supposed to have went to his house, to his apartment in Baltimore. I'm still was living in Upper Marlboro with my mother. So he was like, well, the day before, just come up, you know, come up to my apartment. My brother going to take us up there. I take the day off from work, you know, all that stuff like that. So I'm like, okay, cool. You know, I'll be up there the night before, you know, it was like the night before. Because the appointment, you know, I don't know. I can't remember the time. But anywho, that day came or that night came before the appointment supposed to happen, and I was like, of course I need to tell him because I just don't want to show, you know, just not show up to his apartment. Like, I gotta let him know, like, look, you know, I'm not going to go through with this. So I sent them this long text and was, you know, giving him the reason why I'm keeping my child and I'm not going through with this and this and that. And I'm like, I can raise my baby by myself. You know, if you don't want to be a part of, you know, the child's life, that's fine. You know, I ain't going to push you on no child support because you don't want to have a baby. I'm not that type of person anyway to be putting, especially black males, in the system for some BS when everything is corrupt in the system. You know, like holding y'all up, making y'all life more miserable, not miserable, but just, I don't know. I was just like, I ain't that type of person, so I wasn't going to go that route or whatever. Like, you don't want a baby, fine, I'm not going to force you to have one and be in that child's life. Like, you know, we good. I just raised my baby by myself. So anyways, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Oh, one of these biscuits is small. Oh well, need some small, two small biscuits. And so 10 minutes. This say 14 to 16. And so I sent him this long text message the night before and was like, you know, I ain't gonna come over to your house. You know, I'm keeping my baby. I'm not gonna go through the procedure. Yada, yada, yada. So, shoot. Y'all can only imagine the text messages that he was sending me. He basically done cussed me out. How dare you? You know, you're gonna mess up my life. You messing up your life by having another baby. Your youngest son is only 2 years old, you know. And he was just like, come on, Demetra, please, please, please come over. Please get this done. Please, please, please. Like, you know, like really like pleasing, you know. Like, bring your ass over here tonight because it's getting done tomorrow. You know, like that kind of stuff. You know, calling me and texting me, you know, like after I sent that long text message of, you know, while I'm, you know, keeping my baby. So, So after a couple of his response texts, or, you know, just, you know, he kept sending me all these text messages, which was rude and disrespectful, the stuff that he was saying, you know, I was just like, you know what, let me just block him. And I told him, I was like, I don't got nothing else to say to you. I take care of my baby myself, this and that. Have a good life, you know, take care, basically. So, and I'm making some spaghetti. So let me get this pasta. Where is the rest of it? Okay. So I blocked him. After that, I don't know how many texts he sent after that, but after one last rude one, I was just like, you know what? His ass on block. I don't need to talk to him anymore. You know, we good. So, I'm getting up to the Kool-Aid part. So basically, I had him on block maybe for like 2 weeks or so. Like, it was a while. So we was not in no communication whatsoever, none of that. And then, so I'm going to the park when I was picking up my sons from their dad. You know, they was with their dad for the weekend. I was picking them up. Well, we was meeting up at the Walmart in Clinton, Maryland, you know. on Sunday or whatever. I think it was Sunday. I don't know. But we was meeting up. So we, you know, the boys in my car, and that's when the whole physical altercation happened. That'll be another video when I go in detail about all of that. But, so basically I had, the police was called, you know, they drove off or whatever. So I had to call one of my sisters to come and drive my car because, you know, I didn't want to leave my car in the parking lot, and then my kids had to get home. So I'm like, you know, called my sister, told her what happened. Two of my sisters came up there, the police was there, and, you know, so my sister drove my car and my son back, you know, to my mom's house, to my mom's apartment, while I rode an ambulance to the hospital. So basically, before I got to the, you know, before the police and the ambulance came, well, I think they was already there, I don't know, but I know me and my sister was talking, and my sister was like, well, did you call your baby daddy? She was referring to Melvin, the, you know, like I said, the person I was pregnant with. She was like, did you call him and let him know what happened? That, you know, your baby daddy, you know, wife, and, you know, put her hands on you and you about to go to the hospital, and he just stood there and ain't do nothing and this and that. And I'm like, I'm not calling Melvin. I'm not calling him. I was like, he don't care. I'm like, he, for all I know, he probably, if I tell him, he might be excited. Like, oh, yeah, I hope the baby, you know, hope she lose the baby this way. You know, so I'm like, I'm not calling him. So my sister was like, I call him. So I was like, well, you got to get this, you know, thing off the block. So she ended up calling him and, you know, talking to him or whatever, and then got off the phone with him. And she was just like, well, he said, just keep giving him updates about what's going on or whatever. I'm just like, yeah, whatever. What, you know, so in my head, I'm like, why? So this nigga can pray and hope that I lose the baby, you know, like, I ain't doing all that. But anyway, so I'm at the hospital. They had to do an ultrasound. So I got a picture of the baby. I think I was like 6 weeks old. So, you know, it became like real. And then the doctors did say that the baby is fine. You know, yeah, I wasn't bleeding in that area. So, you know, I did have some streaks. Yes, I ain't gonna say it, trying to say that word again. And some bruises. But other than that, you know, the main thing, the baby was fine, protected. So, and yeah, I think I was like 6 weeks. But basically, when I seen the baby picture, I was like, oh my goodness, look at my baby. I'm sorry, but I was just, oh, like, yeah, I was like, oh my goodness, my baby. So I was like, you know what, let me send this picture to his dad. So I, you know, took a picture of the sonogram, and I sent it to Melvin, his dad. And then he responded like, wow, that's how, you know, the baby looked. Like, far as he, I didn't get a mean vibe from that text. It was just like, oh, okay, well, I hope you and the baby okay. And I think he even, yeah, I think he texted that, like, you know, hope you and the baby okay. So I'm like, oh, I guess he came to a senses that, you know, like, realization that I'm having this baby, you know. So basically left the hospital. Oh my goodness. And then when I got home to my mother to my mother's apartment, mind you, I ain't even tell my mother I was pregnant at this time. Like, I was trying to find the right time to let her know, like, I'm pregnant, I'm about to have another baby. But of course, when this incident happened, like, she had to have find out, you know, she, you know, through my sisters, or, you know, just, hey, this is what happened with Dee Dee. She was assaulted and she's pregnant, you know. So when I got to my mother's house, my mother was like, yeah, so you pregnant? Oh my goodness. But hey, she said what she had to say about it, but that might be another video too. But so basically, you know, I had him, this is Melvin, had him off a block. So I'm going to say not the following weekend, because that was a weekend that I had my sons, but the weekend after that, I went to Baltimore to Melvin's apartment, because throughout this time, throughout these, you know, couple of weeks, you know, further weeks or whatever, me and him, we was texting, he was talking, and he was just like, well, you know, I guess you really is about to have a baby, so hey, can you come over so we can talk this and that face to face? And I'm just like, okay, yeah, I don't mind coming over and talking face to face, you know, that's cool. So, dang it, I thought I had the box of the other spaghetti down. Hold on. Where is? I guess I'm going to use. Okay, so I'm using two different spaghetti boxes. I'm using one that looked like macaroni noodles to get it out the refrigerator, and then the regular whole grain wheat spaghetti. Okay, so I know, like, I should be able to multitask, talk, and do this, right? It's just spaghetti, just putting noodles in some hot water. But so that should be enough. Yeah, that's plenty. Okay, so basically, yeah, he was like, yeah, can you come over so we can talk? And I'm like, yeah, that's fine, we can talk, you know. So that weekend, I went over to his house, and this, I'm bringing up the Kool-Aid. This is the Kool-Aid part. So I went inside his house. He was like, yeah, how you doing? I'm like, I'm good, yada, yada. So we sitting on his couch, and I was in there maybe for like a good, you know, I don't know, 15, 20 minutes or so. So I was like, you got anything to drink? You know, I'm a bit thirsty. He was like, yeah, you know, I got some Kool-Aid. So I'm like, all right, can I get some Kool-Aid? He was like, yeah, sure. So he got up and started, you know, getting the cup. And the way his kitchen is it was like a small, like, galley kitchen. So it's like you can see the cabinet where the cups and stuff at in the sink. But, you know, other than that, you couldn't see the stove. You couldn't see, like, the refrigerator if you open it, this and that or whatever. So anyways, I wasn't really looking at him too much. No way, I was watching the TV. But I heard him, you know, get the glass. Well, I seen him get the glass and or the cup, whatever it was. And, you know, I heard the ice and the Kool-Aid pour, all that. But I was watching the TV. So anyways, he came and sat down right next to me, you know, back on the couch. So he was like, here you go. So this Bama done filled the cup up damn near to the top. You know, it wasn't to the top, but it was like more than half, you know. So I was like, in my head, like, damn, that's a lot of Kool-Aid. So I got the cup from him. So I'm holding the cup. So in my head, I was like, this is a freaking lot of Kool-Aid. So everything was just going on in my mind, like replaying about the assault and how he constantly kept saying, you know, get the termination done. You know, like I said, he ain't used the termination word, but, you know, get that done, yada, yada, yada. And the text messages that he sent me. So I'm like, these two niggas probably in cahoots with each other. They probably planned this. So I'm like, something must be in this Kool-Aid. Like, he filling this sucker all the way up. So I told him, I handed the cup back to him. I was like, can you drink some? And he was like, huh? I was like, yeah, can you drink some? You know, I said, I'm not that thirsty. Can you drink some? He was like, okay. So he drank a little bit. Like, he did drink some, but he drank like a little bit. So, you know, he poured a cup from his mouth and he was like, here you go. I said, nah, can you drink a little bit more? That's still too much. So then he drunken down halfway. So then he handed me the cup and I'm looking at it. I'm like, all right, thank you. Because, you know, I was waiting for a while too before I drink it to see was he going to get up and go to the bathroom. Was he going to, you know, like trying to force something out of his mouth? Was he just going to go to the bathroom in general? You know, so I'm just waiting for a while before I even took a sip. So probably, I don't know, like 5 minutes done passed. Literally, like 5 minutes done passed. He was still sitting down. I still had the cup in my hand. I'm like, all right, I can go ahead and drink this because he ain't, you know, acting funny or whatever. So I'm drinking it. I'm drinking the Kool-Aid. Drinking the Kool-Aid. And so I was telling him, I was like, So is a female going to come over here and trying to beat the baby out of me or something? You know, like I was asking him and he was like, what? No, I said, you ain't going to have none of your cousins or none of your girls to come over here and, you know, trying to start something. Because I said, I know how you is, you know, with the baby, ain't, you know, you ain't want him, you know, ain't want the baby. So he was like, no, I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't do that. So I was like, all right, okay. So he was like, already, I'm past that. I ain't going to do none of that. I was like, all right, cool. So that was it. And yeah, I let him know what I was thinking. Because I'm like, you ain't going to try to hit me with no okie doke and trying to be like, oh, my first attempt, or actually my third attempt, because his first attempt would have been, you know, having the appointment, you know, me going. And then say I walked out. So that would have been the first attempt or whatever. And it didn't work. So then the second attempt would have been sending my first baby daddy and his wife to, you know, assault me to beat the baby out. So that didn't work. So now his third attempt would have been, let me serve her some poisonous Kool-Aid. You know, that would have been like the third one. So, but he, I seen him drink, you know, the Kool-Aid or whatever. And he was fine. So I drank it. So that was it. That's it for this video. There's more videos to come. I'm just trying to get some stuff out while it's on my mind. So, like I said, I don't know if people, y'all need to be careful around people who's offering y'all some drinks, some Kool-Aid, something. If somebody give y'all a bottle of water, bottle of something, make sure y'all top it off. You know, don't like, you know. Y'all seen that movie, The Game. That was an interesting movie, too. When the dude, well, I ain't, yeah, that's a whole nother thing. But, all right, so that's about it. Let me finish cooking.